troubled the water. And whosoever said first after the troubling of the water stepped in was made whole of whatsoever disease he had. And a certain man was there which had an infirmity 38 years.
Yes.
When Jesus saw him lie and knew that he had been now a long time in that case,
yes,
he said unto him, wilt thou be made whole?
Yes.
The impotent man answered him, sir, I am no man when the water is troubled to put me into the pool. But while I am coming, another steppeth down before me. Jesus said unto him, rise, take up thy bed, and walk.
Bless the Lord. We have understood this story, and we heard it before. Praise the Lord. This place in Jerusalem, it's by the sheep market.
Yes.
It is a special place. Praise the Lord. It have five entrances to get into that place. Five entrance, hallelujah, for sick people to get into that place. That place is a special place. We would call it maybe an hospital. Because the Bible said there were all type of people at this place.
Waiting on the angel.
There were blind people.
Yeah, some were crippled.
There were crippled people.
Some were paralyzed.
Amen. There were paralyzed people.
But they were waiting on something.
But they are there waiting for something.
For the moving of the water.
Hallelujah.
They were waiting. And I want to say that everyone that was waiting, they have a hope that something is going to happen to them. They're going to shift, some shift in their circumstances.
Yeah,
there must be some shift, hallelujah, in their physical, hallelujah, body. So they were there waiting.
For the troubling of the water.
And they were waiting for the troubling of the water.
Yeah,
hallelujah. They were there, praise the Lord, knowing that the water is going to trouble, but they don't know when the water is going to trouble, but they know that the water is going to trouble. Hallelujah. So they were there waiting. And they were there with that expectation that something is going to happen to them. Hallelujah. I want to tell you today, praise the Lord, too long you have been in your situation.
Crippled state.
Yeah.
Too long you have been crippled and in that crippled state.
Yes. Too long impotent.
Too long you have been impotent.
Come on.
You have been in the church, but you still impotent. You are in the church, but you still crippled.
Yes, like I'm sure.
Somebody would say, Pastor, I am in the church for 38 years.
Yes.
Sometimes 40 years. But I still have the same, hallelujah, ignorant spirit that plagued me from my mother and my father coming down into my generation.
Yes, born with it.
We are in an impotent state.
Yeah.
Jesus, hallelujah, was looking and passing this way. The water was troubled. The impotent man, I could picture, just picture in your mind, the impotent man. Every time he tried to get into the water, someone stepped right in. Hallelujah. To me, that seems very unfair. That seems very unfair, eh? Praise the Lord. That every time I want to make a move, something happens and take my blessing away. Something happens that I don't get to get out of my crippled situation. Something happened, hallelujah, that I don't get the healing that I'm supposed to get. Something happened that I don't get the change in my life that I should get in my life. I want to tell you something. Jesus is on his way. Hallelujah. Jesus is right here, right now. Hallelujah. Jesus is here right now. Hallelujah. So the man have a need. And he said, listen to me. Hallelujah. Jesus passing that way now. And Jesus get inside that place where all those sick people were. Praise the Lord. Yeah. Who know that Jesus seek out to find the lost? Yeah. Who know that Jesus seek out to find the sick? Who know that Jesus seek to find the helpless? Who know that Jesus seek out to find those caught who don't know the way? Jesus said, that's the purpose. I am here. And I want to tell you something. That's the purpose why you get saved. God Almighty, to help someone on the way. Hallelujah. So Jesus get inside the hospital.
Yes. And when he saw this man lost.
Jesus. The God in flesh. Hallelujah. And he come upon this man.
And when Jesus saw him.
What the Bible said.
And when Jesus saw him lie, and knew that he had been
crippled
a long time in that case.
Bless the Lord.
He said unto him, without be made whole.
God. Jesus saw the man into his situation. For 38 years. And Jesus, hallelujah, the deliverer, yeah. The one that come to set you free, yeah. The one that come to make you free, yeah, the one that come to lift your heavy load, hallelujah. So Jesus saw the man into his crippled state, hallelujah. He moved with compassion and love. Yeah. Praise the Lord. He moved, praise the Lord, hallelujah, to deliver someone out of their situation. Yeah. Touch a person and said, God can deliver you out of your situation. Yeah. Look at them and said, God, look in their face, praise the Lord. God can deliver you out of your situation. Your situation ain't too hard for God. God is getting ready to do something for you. Praise the Lord. So Jesus asked the man. Jesus could, and that is the part that grab hold of me. Jesus could immediately. Jesus could immediately heal the man without asking no question. Hallelujah. Jesus could easily tell the man, get up. Take up your bed. And walk. Hallelujah. But Jesus, that's the part that grab hold of me. Jesus asked the man a question. Hallelujah. Jesus asked him a question. Hallelujah. And said to him, do you, praise the Lord, the Amplified Version said, hallelujah. And Jesus asked him the question and said,
do you want to become well?
Do you want to become well?
Are you really in earnest need?
Jesus, look at the man and see him in 38 years. Whether he has some excuse or he don't have no excuse, because sometimes we have excuse to stay crippled.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Sometimes we have excuse why I ain't doing that. Why you not doing that? You know, I fell, I hurt, but you know, I don't feel like. Hallelujah. Sometimes we get so comfortable in our situation. Hallelujah. But I want to tell you something today. Don't be comfortable in your situation. Hallelujah. Because the deliverer is passing your way. Jesus is passing your way. And no matter what is your situation, he's able to deliver you out of it. But one thing I want to tell you today, that he's not going to force himself upon you. He's not going to bad handle and take you by the neck and pull you through the gutter and through the grind to get you to the right thing. Hallelujah. Because the God that we serve, he set apart a time in which he's going to deal with every man according to his word. So since he knows that he set a time to deal with every man according to his work, he make it a choice. So touch the person and say, I have a choice. Touch him and say, I have a choice. Touch him and say, I have a choice. I have a choice to live right. I have a choice. I have a choice to live right. I have a choice. Hallelujah. To live like a devil. I have a choice. God give me that choice. Hallelujah. God give me that choice. And he said, choose this day who you shall serve. If it's God, it's God serving. If Baal is Baal serving. But there's going to come a time when God going to separate. Hallelujah. So it come to the time where Jesus asked this man, will thou be made old? Ask him the question. He asked him the question. God Almighty. The man now in a position that he cannot find no excuse now because deliverance come his way. Hallelujah. Deliverance come his way. So either he has to take deliverance or he can stay is an incompetent or is crippled position. But he has a choice. Every one of us here right now, sitting under my voice, you have a choice. You have a choice. It is a choice. He's a choice. Either I make it to heaven or I make it to hell. There is no in between heaven and hell, but there is a choice. Hallelujah. I want to say, praise the Lord. If you live right, you talk right, you do the right thing, you ain't doing it for the pastor. God Almighty, you ain't doing it for the sister. Hallelujah. You ain't doing it for your husband, or you ain't doing it for your brother. If you live right, you're doing it for yourself. If you walk right, you're doing it for yourself. So God is saying, make a choice. Come on now, make a choice. Hello, Walter, make a choice. It's a choice I know. Hallelujah. Choose this day, my brothers and sisters, who you shall serve. If God is God, you heard the word. Serve him. Hallelujah. You ain't too young to serve God. Somebody said, I'm too young to serve God. Hallelujah. I heard that a 8-year-old baby take up a gun and shoot. Hallelujah. His family and kill them. A 8-year-old. Hallelujah. If a 8-year-old is able to take up that responsibility, a 8-year-old is able to take up the responsibility. I said, I want to serve God. Hallelujah. So it comes now that the man have, hallelujah, a choice.
Yes.
And God, Jesus said to him now, make your choice.
Yes.
Hallelujah. He said to him, he said, do you want to be whole? Do you want to be whole?
Oh my God.
Jesus asking the question, do you want to be saved?
Yeah.
Do you want to be saved? Uh-huh. Hallelujah. This heavy burden, too hard for me to carry.
My God,
the deliverer is on.
Is here.
Is here right now.
Yeah,
Jesus said right now, hallelujah, you want to be whole. So Jesus, he said, what he said?
The impotent man answered him, sir.
The impotent man
answered him and said, sir.
Answer Jesus.
I have no man. When the water is troubled.
When water troubled.
To put me into the pool.
To put me in the pool.
But while I'm coming, another step it down before me.
Somebody step inside the pool before me.
But Jesus.
Someone step inside the pool before me because I have a crippled position. I'm a impotent position. If I don't get in the pool by somebody lifting me in the pool, I will not, God Almighty, get healed. But I want to tell you, nobody don't have to lift you in this pool. Jesus is right here, right now, moving, giving you the choice. Hallelujah. Jesus said to the man,
My God.
Rise up.
Yeah.
God tell him, I'm going to shift you to your position. God Almighty, I'm going to shift you out of your crippled situation. He said, listen to me now. Rise up.
Take up your bed.
Take up your bed. Take up your bed. Take up your bed. And walk. Too long you are in the crippled situation. God is saying right now, get up from your position. Get up from your situation. Come on now, shake off. Get up and shake off. Get up and shake off. Get up and shake off yourself. Shake off yourself. I want you to shake off your situation. Hallelujah. Shake off. I'm talking now to the people of God. Shake off your bad heart. God Almighty, shake off the bad heart. Shake off the bad heart. Too long you have it. Too long you are in that situation. Shake off the heart. I want to shake off malice. God is saying, I want to shake off envy. God Almighty, shake it off. Too long I'm in that situation. That situation made me crippled. So that situation made me crippled. That situation made me crippled. God Almighty, shake off envy. Shake off strife. Shake off malice. God Almighty. I heard some saved folks say, Pastor, you know how long I've been upset with somebody? I said, how long have you been upset? I've been upset with them from our back in Jamaica. And I am still upset with them right here, right now. I said, how long you been in church? I've been in church from I was 30 hard years. I said, listen to me. You are in a crippled situation. Too long you are in that situation. God is saying, shake it off. Shake it off. God, I said, you know you're lucky, you're never dead. I said, you're lucky, you're never dead. God maybe have a plan for you while you're never dead. Because if you did dead when you have somebody in your heart, all that 30 odd years gone straight down the drain. Say straight down the drain. That's the person that says straight down the drain. Straight down the drain. Straight down the drain. We sometimes be judgmental in ourselves. Judgmental that I see you and I don't like you, but I analyze you and I pick you up. And then I say, the Spirit said, I'm stepping in now. The Spirit said, God. But sometimes it's my mind. Amen. You know, sometimes your mind plays some trick on you.
Amen.
You know, sometimes your mind, praise the Lord. And then you say, Spirit say, hallelujah. The Bible said, shake it off. Hallelujah. If I can help someone on the way, hallelujah. Shake yourself. Come on. Shake yourself. Turn your ears. Hallelujah. Sometimes we wonder why we're not blessed. You know you can stop the blessing.
Amen.
You know you can stop the blessing.
Holy.
You can stop the blessing. The word of God said, hallelujah. If you be hearken,
diligently
to what I say unto you.
Yeah.
That means to the word of God.
Yeah.
I will bless your going out. And I'm going to bless your coming in. Touch a person and say, nobody can stop my blessing but me. Touch him and say, touch him. Touch him. Touch him. Young man, wake up, man. Wake up. Nobody can stop your blessing but you. Praise the Lord. I want you to understand. Jesus is passing your way. Jesus is passing this way. And no matter what the situation, he can change it around. No matter how it look hard, and no matter who give up on you. No matter how it might seem that everything that I try, it fails me. I go to school, and since I put on the name of Jesus, they're judging me. I try to live against evil. But every time I try to do good, evil presents itself. God is saying, get up. Rise up. No matter what is your position, rise up. I know every one of us here is into a position. So many in position of sickness. So maybe in position of no money, no money, no dummy. No dummy, no there. No money, no there. Poor.
Bless the Lord, oh my Lord. Hallelujah.
No money, no there.
But God.
Some of us need somewhere to live. And we can't find a way to live. It's hard. Some of us, the children, is in trouble. Husband giving trouble.
Holy God.
Wife giving trouble. Some of us try to make two ends meet, but every time we do it, it drift away.
Holy God.
But I want to say to someone, Jesus is passing your way. Jesus is passing your way. My sister, Jesus is passing your way. Everything I try, it failed me. The woman said, I have an issue of blood for 33 years. She bleeding. I've been to the doctor. I've been everywhere. I spend my money on everything that I hear.
Yeah.
And everything failed. But I heard that Jesus is passing this way. Said, I heard that Jesus is passing this way. Who hear that Jesus is passing that way? Who hear that Jesus is passing that way?
Hallelujah.
God is talking to someone today. You don't have to go home back, be the same. Oppressed. Sick or lame. No matter who you are, God is saying to you, you don't have to go through it all by yourself. I'm here to deliver someone right now. The water is troubled. The water is troubled. If you need prayer, come right up now. If you need God to touch you right now, come up right now. God is getting ready. God is getting ready. God is getting ready. Sometimes we hear the word of God and we harden our hearts and we say, it's not me. And I just sit still. And God pass you on the other side. And you still remain the same. God is calling someone right now.
Longing for pardon today.
Evangelist. Evangelist.